Well, 1 year ago today, Robert Mueller was appointed to lead the investigation of Russian meddling into the 2016 election. The Senate Intelligence Committee said yesterday it agrees with the U.S. intelligence community's assessment that Russia's government acted in part to help Donald Trump win the GOP nomination. Nancy Cordes is on Capitol Hill with a report that's put committee Republicans on opposite sides from their counterparts in the House. Nancy, good morning.
Good morning. After 14 months of investigating this, the Senate Intelligence Committee says that unlike its House counterpart, it sees no reason to doubt the intelligence community's assessment from 2016. As Mark Warner, the top Democrat on the Senate Intelligence Committee, put it, Russia's election interference was ordered by President Putin himself for the purpose of helping Donald Trump and hurting Hillary Clinton. Now, this is at odds with the House Intelligence Committee, which said back in March that it concurs with the rest of the intelligence community's assessment, except with respect to Putin's supposed preference for candidate Trump. They believe that he simply wanted to shake up the U.S. election system, a conclusion that President Trump liked a lot better. Yesterday, a separate Senate committee released transcripts of its interview with Donald Trump Jr., in part regarding his June 2016 Trump Tower meeting with a Russian lawyer. Trump Jr. confirmed to the Judiciary Committee that he was interested in dirt on Hillary Clinton, but didn't think that there was anything wrong with attending that meeting. His explanation, however, conflicts with his initial description of the meeting over a year ago when he said that it was simply set up to discuss Russian adoptions. Norah?
All right, Nancy, thank you so much.